Just about everybody at some point or another will realize that they have moved out of one stage in their life and are moving into another. A number of years ago, I realized that was actually something that had happened to me. And I can genuinely say that I do feel as though that I have been living abroad too long. But what do I mean by that? Roll that intro. Hello there, I'm Rafael Di Furia, back at it again for another Friday night. And yes, Santa may have his elves and helpers, but I had one this year, and that's why this tree is up here behind me. So anyway, thanks to the little elf who helped. But to get into this topic, the thing is that when I say that I feel as though I have been living abroad too long, it's not that I've lived in another country for too long, lived in another part of the world for too long. It's that I, at some point, ended up shifting out of the living abroad mentality. Even though I talk about it on this YouTube channel a lot, I feel as though that it has become my daily reality. So I'm not necessarily abroad anymore. I am a guy living his life on the other side of the world, and I happen to live in a location currently that I was not raised in. So that's the thing, is what I'm kind of getting at here. But there is a certain point when you are living abroad that you will realize that things are becoming a lot less fresh, a lot less new, a lot less unique, and a lot less exciting. I mean, okay, of course, when you're interacting with something new, a new surroundings, yeah, there's going to be all these new connections being made into your brain, and that's going to be very exciting and setting off all these signals in the background and all that stuff, whatever scientific mumbo-jumbo. Mumbo-jumbo. Science is not mumbo-jumbo. Different discussion for a different day, but hope you get what I mean here, that there are going to be those connections made in the brain. And once you get used to it, it's not quite as immediately exciting in that it just makes you jump out of your chair. But you have to learn how to keep those things exciting. Learn how to become a tourist in your own location. So living in Portugal, for example, yeah, it's a place that I've had some familiarity with. And it's not like, oh, everything is so new. And even before living in Portugal. But that's what I can say, is that even in Europe, I don't know. I hate to say this, and I know it's going to offend a lot of people, but I think there is something that maybe some people will understand what I mean by this, that when you are traveling around many large European cities, that there is something that kind of feels the same everywhere you go. And in some ways, things don't always feel like so quintessentially, whatever it may be, German, Italian, French, English, Portuguese, that, okay, you feel like you're in a European city, but you see the same exact magnets and the same exact foods. And now, okay, maybe not the same foods, other than McDonald's, of course, the Golden Archways, the American embassy to all, at least cultural or gastronomical, but different story again for a different day. But how is it that you can keep things exciting for you? And that is by trying new things, doing new things, going to new places, and pushing yourself in directions that you might not have in the past. I can say that's actually something for me over the past few years, is that I have been consciously pushing myself to go do things that I wouldn't normally have, experiences I wouldn't normally. I mean, nothing crazy. I'm not living a wild lifestyle here. I like to keep things actually kind of on the chill side. But what I'm saying is to go and have experiences and go to places, see things, try things. I like trying things anyway, but I'm saying maybe taking that extra little step outside of my comfort zone, because I can so easily fall into a rhythm and say, okay, I'm going to eat this same thing and go to this same place and have this same water or this same this or this same that and have the same thing. I could so easily do the exact same thing every day without even thinking twice about it. But why would you want to live life on rails? Why would you want to be able to move through your life in such a way that you never have to really think about things? That could get pretty boring pretty quickly, but being able to say maybe take a little bit of a different route down the road, or maybe onto your destination that you have to go to, like maybe work every day, take a different route, walk down a different street, stop looking down at the ground when you are walking in front of you, look up at eye level, look up at the sky, look up at just period, look up at what's around you, because you will sometimes see things that might not have been in your reality. And I think there are so many times where we get blinders, and this actually happened literally today. I was going to a cafe to meet someone, and that was exactly what I had on my mind, and nothing else was in my reality. And apparently I walked by somebody who I know from just kind of the Braga scene of expats and people who live here, and then I bumped into that person's spouse who was a little bit further in there, who had stopped me, and I almost wasn't even recognizing this person as well. So there are those times where we do put ourselves into something that is so familiar that it just becomes that we can live our life without any new interactions. So what are the new interactions that you can put in front of your own life? So yeah, I know there are plenty of you who are actually looking at living abroad for that new way of kind of making something fresh and having a different experience than what you may have experienced otherwise. But what happens when you are living in the same place for 2 years and you've gotten used to it, 3 years and you're really used to it, 5 years and maybe you're starting to think, maybe it's time for a new adventure, but you're not wanting to move. Maybe you will want to move. Maybe you won't want to move. Maybe you're the type of person who really wants to set down some roots. In that case, of course, it's still very important to be able to learn how to keep things fresh. Try a new restaurant, try a different cafe, go to the bar that maybe you thought was a little sketchy, and go there one time in the middle of the afternoon when things are okay, and have that that moment that you know is not something that you would normally. And who knows, maybe you'll meet someone new and have a fun interaction with them, and maybe it's only ever going to be that one time, because there are so many moments in life that only happen once and only deserve to live in that moment that you can't replicate, nor should you replicate. And that, I think, is very important when you're living in another country, is to figure out what it is that you can do to keep those things new and keep those things fresh and have those new experiences. That's why, so even for me, when I say that I've lived abroad for too long, I don't necessarily see that as a bad thing. I can say that, yes, there are many things that to me have just become like the norm, that maybe I'm not going to understand every last word perfectly said. Maybe I am going to miss certain friends and family members. Maybe I'm going to miss certain foods that I had access to in another part of the world that I lived in. Of course, it's not your average Globetrotter food. We have to talk about these things. Very important. But even those things that are familiar to you, of course, you don't want to just rub them out and just erase them from your experience. There are going to be those things that you need at the end of the day that are familiar. Your little snack, or your little dessert, or your little candy, or for whatever reason, Americans like Q-tips and have to have those every time someone goes to America and have those brought to them. I still don't understand why. It's been 15 years and I still don't get it. All those Ziploc baggies, those are very special. Those should be respected. But also what I would say is that for as much as you want to experience things and have new adventures, and when you first arrive in a place, you want to see and try and do everything new, you also don't want to overload yourself. That is, I would say, for many, actually an easy trap to fall into. Not that everybody does this, but there are some, or not that it even happens to everybody, but what can happen is that people, they just get there. They're like, okay, we have to do this, we have to do that, we have to see this, we have to see that. And maybe actually at the first week, month, couple months are going to be the easiest time, because you're in that transition period, maybe before you're getting into your new job, or maybe you're working abroad from your job that you had before. Of course, circumstances depend on individual situations. But when you have so many new connections in the brain and so many new things happening all the time, it can be overwhelming for some people. So that's why I would say also, when you're moving into a new country, when you're moving into a new life, take one step in, like a hot tub. Don't just jump in head first. Yeah, maybe for some people it works that you just burn, or have the sensation of burning everything off. But my personal quote unquote methodology when it comes to a hot tub, even though it's probably been like, what, 17 years since I was last in one, is that first you put one foot in, acclimate, you get the other foot in, and then you take another little step down and you go a little bit deeper and a little bit deeper, and your body gets used to it as you're getting in. And then all of a sudden you get to a point where you can fully immerse yourself or get yourself neck deep. And that could just be enough. And by that time, you've had those moments to slowly work your way in. That can help you to really appreciate the warm feeling in a quite literal sense. And I would say this for most things in life, that if you are putting yourself into a new situation, that having some sort of way that you can ease into things is definitely ideal. But of course, there are certain moments where jumping headfirst is actually the best thing. And sometimes you just have to let the moment roll. If you have a certain situation in your life where you see that there's just this natural evolution of things, sometimes you have to roll with those moments. You sometimes have to go with what is put in front of you. I'm not going to get spiritual or esoterical here. At least I'm going to try not to. I do believe that maybe there are certain moments where you just kind of have to trust in the moment and have a little faith and maybe putting yourself a little bit out there and just allowing for the moment to flow. Of course, you have to do it with a little bit of wisdom and understanding of the moment that, okay, you're not going to put yourself into a dangerous situation, but don't put yourself in a position where opportunities coming your way are just going to bounce off of you and go back to where they're from, ricochet completely away from you. When you put yourself into a new situation and being open to having these possibilities is also very important. So, of course, it all comes down to having a balance in life. That's just simply what it is. And that's why I was saying, have your moments, have your exciting adventures, but also remember what is kind of comforting to you. But maybe see, is there a way that you can put them all together? Put those new excited moments and those new adventures together with your comfort zone and figure out where they match up between. Because for many people, when you are starting to explore a new country, like I said, it's very easy to get overwhelmed because you've got all this new food that you've never heard of before and you don't know what to try first, or maybe it's not appealing to you and maybe you miss your mac and cheese from back at home. But maybe there's something that's the midway point between what your culture presents and or what your country presents and the new location where you are. Definitely try the cuisine where you are and try to embrace those things. But of course, there are going to be certain things that for some may be difficult. Like I've mentioned in so many episodes of Not Your Average Globetrotter, the very traumatic incident I had in Italy where I found horse on my pizza. Yes, horse meat on pizza. It's a thing. You can even buy steaks and shredded meat at the supermarket. But again, another subject for another day. Although that day may never come on your average Globetrotter. But yeah, there are going to be certain adventurous moments. And those who are maybe a little bit into different things that are a little bit out there, they might be able to embrace that a little bit easier. But you also have to realize what your comfort level is and how far beyond that you can push. But rather than blabber on too much longer, I think I'm going to round out this episode of Not Your Average Globetrotter here. So, of course, a huge thank you to those of you who helped to make these episodes possible on a monthly basis through rafaeldifuria.com/Patreon, patreon.com/rafaeldifuria, as well as the one-time donations such as the thanks button here on YouTube. It's because of all of you that this project is able to continue. I'm Rafael Di Furia. Stay safe and healthy out there, and I will see you all next Friday for another episode of Not Your Average Globetrotter. Later.